I have been trying to warn you guys. The Denver Nuggets are inevitable. And last night, they proved that because this was a game that the Denver Nuggets should not have won. The Lakers were up by 20. The Lakers were up by 20. And this is really bad for the Lakers. If you're a Lakers fan right now, I mean, you can't be feeling good about this because in game one, the Lakers had a lead at halftime on the road. You know, you lose that one. All right. This one had a 20-point lead near halftime. I don't know if it was exactly halftime, but near halftime, they had a 20-point lead, and they end up blowing it. I'm recording this right after the game because I'm just in shock still. I feel like I gotta talk about these games. First off, the Knicks and Sixers series is insane. That game ended in a crazy way, which I'll be dropping a video about that. So sub up, turn on noties so you guys don't miss that video. We're also about to hit 2K subs, so subscribe before we hit 2,000. Be an OG sub. I still consider that, you know, an early sub on this channel. But the Lakers Nuggets game, like both of those, the back-to-back doubleheader on TNT might have been the best back-to-back in NBA playoff history. So if you for some reason didn't watch this game, again, the Lakers had a 20-point lead near halftime and they ended up losing the game by two. There's a lot that goes into this. Anthony Davis had 32 points, but most of those points were in the first quarter, not in the first quarter, the first half. But in the second half, AD essentially went ghost. He also did have five fouls, but he still played 39 minutes, led the team in minutes, so that didn't really matter. Rui Hachimura with an absolute stinker, 3 points. LeBron James, 26 points, 12 assists, 8 boards, almost a triple-double. In my opinion, he's the reason they were in this game. I mean, AD in the first half, yeah, that's pretty much how they got the lead. But in the second half, it wasn't looking good. Nuggets kept clawing back into this game. And LeBron James in a fourth quarter, I mean, I'm going to pull up some clips. Back-to-back threes. He had this one steal into a dunk. And he was going off. It's not a masterclass by LeBron, but it was a really good game by him. He did miss a shot pretty much for the game with like 20 seconds left. But he was the only reason that they were even in that spot in the first place. Also, D'Lo started the game red hot, 23 points. He had like 9 points in the first quarter off all 3-pointers, maybe even more than that. Austin Reeves, 9 points, pretty much not a good game for him. And then the bench really did nothing. Only 6 points off the bench, which came from Torian Prince. If we look at the Nuggets, Jokic had 27, MPJ had 22. He had a really good game. Aaron Gordon with 14, Jamal Murray with 20, and the game winner. I mean, anytime you hit a game winner in the playoffs, it's just iconic. And I'm going to pull it up in a second in case you guys haven't seen it, but it was an insane shot. Christian Brown also off the bench, 10 points. That really helped them, especially in the second half. So if you guys didn't end up seeing the end of this game, of course, it was 99-99 with 6 seconds left. I thought they might have went to Jokic because Jokic, first off, in this game, especially at the end of the game, was just having his way with Anthony Davis, which I don't know why. Well, AD is a great defender. Let me not just take that away from him. It's just Jokic's offense is that good. But AD's talking about, I don't know why I'm not in the DPOY consideration. They just don't want to give it to me. He said something along those lines. I mean, it is Jokic, so you kind of got to cut him some slack. But Jokic, I mean, was just having his way with AD. Pause. Not like that, but you know what I'm saying? Like, AD didn't stand a chance. Like, if Jokic wanted to score, it seemed like he could whenever. So I thought they might have went to Jokic here, but 3 seconds, Jamal Murray went to the right wing with Anthony Davis, which I was like, I don't know. I don't know how I like this. You know, obviously you got to try and step back because you try to drive on AD. He's probably going to block it. And Jamal Murray does just that, kind of a fadeaway. Oh my God. I mean, into the bench too. Like, the bench just collapsed on him in like celebration. This was crazy. Again, anytime you hit a game winner in the playoffs, even in the regular season, it's crazy. But in the playoffs, it's absolutely iconic. Like, I can't even just imagine being a Nuggets fan in this arena. Must be insane. But this is just the icing on the cake for me. Like, this is the game that the Lakers should have won. The Lakers are a very good team, by the way. They're a very good team. And they've been in both of these games on the road in Denver. And this game really felt like the Lakers were going to win it. I thought the series was going to go 1-1. Again, they had a 20-point lead. You cannot lose games where you have a 20-point lead at about halftime. And again, I think LeBron played a really good game. He did miss a shot with like 20 seconds left that might have given them the win. Probably would have given them the win. But, and he's done this many times in his career where he gets his team to that situation. He keeps them in it. Then he misses a shot at the end and everyone just goes off on him. Yeah, he missed the shot, but what do you want the dude to, like, you want him to go perfect the whole game? Like, I don't know. You just can't expect that from him. And also, there was like a stretch from like 3-ish minutes, 2.5 to like pretty much that last shot, 30 seconds, where like he wasn't even touching the ball. KCP was kind of pressing on him, so it was like hard for him to get him the ball. But like, I think Austin Reeves took a shot, D'Lo took a shot. It's like, you gotta get LeBron the ball, especially when he's hot. Because if you guys didn't see, of course, right here, this is the second three, but he had back-to-back threes. I mean, he's pulling up from like near the logo with a hand in his face. He was going off. I don't know how they lose this game. I don't. Because even right here, 8-point lead. Might be hard to see. Yeah, 8-point lead with 5 minutes to go. It's like, it just doesn't make sense. And then right here with a minute 30, this is where he scored. And I was like, finally, he's touching the ball. But it was because of himself. He gets a steal, runs the break, and dunks on Jamal Murray, essentially. This was crazy. Like, I remember I was talking to Henry. If you guys, you know, watch my 2K videos, you know who that is. And I was like, this is the end of like LeBron's career. And this is just insane to watch. He's 39 years old and he's playing like this. Like, he's keeping a team in it against the defending champs. Well, I mean, keeping them in it is kind of crazy again, considering they had a 20-point lead. But this is really bad for the Lakers. Obviously, being down 2-0 in a series against a team that everyone expects, not expects, but they're like the favorite to go to the NBA Finals. So the best team in the West, essentially. That's not a great sign. Now they're going back to LA. But again, it would have been nice if they could take one of those games that they had leads in both of them, especially this game where they had a 20-point lead. I can't even stress that enough. It would have been nice to go, you know, 1-1 back to LA. That would be a great situation because you win both games at LA. Now you're up 3-1. Just got to win one more. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of easy. But now the Lakers put themselves in a spot where you're down 2-0. You pretty much have to win these next two games. In LA, I mean, you got to win both these games. And the Nuggets have not, they've been playing good, but like, it kind of feels like they just, again, they had to take one of these because it feels like the Nuggets are due for like a blowout win. These first two games are close, but it kind of feels like the Nuggets are due for like a blowout win coming up here in either game three or four. That's just what it feels like to me. And this is not good for the Lakers because is it likely that they win both games in LA, games three and four? No, it's not likely at all that the Lakers do that, but they pretty much have to because you win those two. Now it's 2-2, goes back to Denver. If you win that, that's crazy because then you go back to LA, you could win four straight, but is that gonna happen? Probably not, because the Lakers, the last 10 games they've played the Nuggets are 0-10. This is going back, you know, 2-3 years, but they haven't beat the Nuggets in their last 10 games against them. Not a singular win. Last season in the Western Conference Finals, they obviously got swept by the Nuggets. The Nuggets went on to win it all. But like, this is bad. This is a really bad look. And I feel like looking back on history, you know, you're not going to remember all these little shots in the game. You know, LeBron keeping them in it, hitting two threes, getting that steal on Jamal Murray, then dunking on him on the other end. You're not going to remember all of those things unless you're just an NBA like nerd or something. But you're going to look back and you're going to be like, wow, LeBron, you know, got first round, that he just got swept by Jokic, maybe get swept again here. Like, you know, and it just feels like LeBron played great. AD as well, 32-point triple-double. Actually, not, I'm tripping, 2 assists. 32-point double-double. But I don't know. I don't know. This is a game the Lakers had to win, and they didn't. So I'm not going to say the series is over, but it's pretty much over. Like, what do I give them? Like a 1%, 2% chance of coming back now? If they pull off this comeback, that would be an insane comeback. I just don't expect them to win both games in LA. But if they do, this series will definitely be interesting. All I'm going to say is that we are like, what, 3 days into the playoffs? And this is crazy. Like, the games we're seeing is crazy outside of like the Cavs and Magic, because that series is kind of, I don't even think they had it on national television. Like, it was on like the, it was on, what was it, like NBA TV or something. Like, they're not even putting it on like ABC, TNT, like, you know what I'm saying? ESPN, something like that. It wasn't even on TV. Like, that's how bad of a series that is, I guess, for like ratings and stuff. So if you guys haven't, I will be dropping a video on the Knicks game as well. That's probably out right now. So make sure y'all check that out.